recording.
Oh, goody. Alrighty. Hi, and welcome back to Three Sisters Knit. This is episode 7.
I can't believe we've done seven already. Woo! Or we're at 7.
Yes.
It's exciting. So, yes, it is. Hello to our old friends, anybody who's been with us, watched us in the past, welcome back.
And from the beginning.
And if you're new, welcome. I hope you find something interesting in what we talk about as we move forward. So as Sheila said, this is the Three Sisters Knit podcast. Also, we just shorten it to TSK. My name is Margaret. You can find me on Ravelry as Magpie60.
And I'm Sheila, and I am on Ravelry as Shishi62.
And we are on Instagram together as Three Sisters Knit. So you can follow us there, see mm-hmm. what we're working on. Anything else that happens to be going on in our lives.
Yeah.
So welcome back.
Yes.
We actually have a lot to talk about this time.
Yes.
If you joined us last time, you know that we were on a road trip, and we did post a few photos as we were traveling. Not an awful lot, but we did post some.
On our Instagram.
So we will talk a little bit about that. So we want to get through first. We want to talk about our WIPs and FOs.
Mm-hmm.
So do you want to start with yours?
Okay. We have one FO between the two of us.
Yes.
I finished my Pure Joy.
It's so nice.
And we thought it was looking smaller than the other one. I still think it is a little smaller than the other one that I did, the blue one.
Yeah.
But this one is so, so nice.
Look how pretty that turned out.
It did. It turned out
it's
really pretty.
It's really unique looking.
And it's interesting because here's a little spot right there that you can see that's not pink. You can see it sort of yellow right there.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there's the odd little green dot and yellow dot in amongst the pink. Not very much. There's only about 3 or 4 of them, but it's just very interesting. So it's done.
It's so pretty.
And it's so soft. It's washed and blocked and all the ends are sewn in. So it is done. So there we go.
Yeah.
I might be giving that to someone.
It's gorgeous. Gorgeous.
That's it.
So that's the only FO we have this time around. So do you want... The only one I'm going to show this week is my... Pendulum. I was hoping to have it finished because my friend is getting married on Saturday on the 17th, and I was hoping to have it to wear with a dress. I just haven't been able to get it finished. I'm working away on it. While we were away, Sheila drove
all the driving,
and then I was the navigator. And I really didn't get into, because we were going to places that we didn't really know, I really tried to be on the ball as far as what was happening on the road and stuff. So I really didn't knit in the car, which I have done
sometimes. She is a very good navigator.
So I haven't done as much of this, but I've got a lot done. I'm like really close to being finished. So I'm going to take it out. I've got it in my little stitch holder here.
From
Zigzag.
Zigzag Stitches.
And so this is what I have done. It's come along really, really well. So let's see. Look how pretty. Oh, I'm so happy with how it's turned out. So as you can see, it's pendulum because on the side that I'm holding up, the it's thicker. The solid is thicker, and then the variegated is thinner. And then as you move across, it reverses through the use of short rows, and it just is such a pretty, pretty way. And if you lift it up a little bit, you can kind of see my, it's the other way around. Got it the wrong way. I've got my progress keeper way down at the bottom there. So you can see that's where I was the last time when I got started. I have made headway. I thought I would get it done, but I've just started on this little piece here is actually going to be the very last variegated section.
Just got 2 more sections to
go. I've got that to do, and then another solid, and then a bind off. So it's coming along really well, but it's just not going to be finished by the time I need it on Saturday.
Too bad.
Which is too bad, but I thought I might wear the the Pure Joy that I made. I have a bluish sort of dress, and I think that I love blue and brown, I think, are really nice complementary colors. So I thought, I have this kind of bluish dress I'm considering wearing, and I thought it would look really pretty with that, with the brown Pure Joy that I made a couple of weeks ago. So that's the plan now. And that was always kind of a backup plan, but I was hoping that it wouldn't have to be. I was
hoping it wouldn't have to be.
Yes.
Yes. I wanted to show you what I'm doing on my cozy memory blanket, because I think I was around here the last time. Well, I've done two rows and started on a third row since then.
Yeah, I think the last time you talked about it, you had just added these yellow.
Yeah, the whole yellow row. Yes.
And so you've added quite a bit since then.
Yes. The way I did the yellow, I started at the light. You hold that side. Okay. Started at the light, and I went darker, 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 darker all the way along. This one I dyed, this yellow one right here, is one of the ones that I dyed. Sorry, here we go.
Yeah.
There.
Yeah, that one's pretty. If you go on our shop, I think that one is showing up in our shop, the Raina shawl.
Yes.
We have that, Sheila knitted up into a shawl, and we're actually selling it.
Yeah.
So you can maybe see a little bit closer as well.
And so this one I started with the blue, the lighter blue, and sort of went along around. But the orange, the way I was doing it, I sort of go back and forth like this so that I don't just go up here. And then, because then you sort of, this place is always the last one that you do on on a row anyways. So,
well, orange is another really nice complementary color to blue. So it that was
what I did with my my first Pure Joy was that one. So that turned out really, really nicely with that. And you did something in this blue green one.
Yeah, that was it's actually one of the things that we sold in the shop.
Yes.
My rebel scarf. It was a cowl that I had designed myself, but I love that. That was a sweet Georgian yarn. So,
and that was that's the I did the Hermione's Everyday Sock with the gold, and that's that one there
for your son's girlfriend, right?
Yeah,
yeah.
And that's nice. The Picasso Moon. And then I went just before we left. I went to our local yarn store, Soper Creek Yarns, and I bought a bunch of Koigu minis.
Oh, nice.
So are all these three and these two. Oh, these four and these two are the minis that I bought. This is from the Pure Joy I just finished, and so is this black up at the top here.
Oh, neat.
And then these two are from your Pure Joy.
Yes.
The brown ones. Yeah. So these are just the Koigu, and I just decided to go dark, light, light, dark. Like, sort of do a light, dark alternating one like that.
That's
so
neat.
That's all I did. And so I'm just going to try to alternate. I'll get a lighter one here. And I just think going light, dark will be kind of neat. That's how I'm going to do the rest of it. And I was just, we were just talking before we recorded. And so like, so I've done that. I've got 37 squares with this one little black one. What I'm considering doing, because this knits as a square, it just gets a bigger and bigger square. What I might do is make it to a certain point and do an edging and then start another one until it gets to the same size and do another edging. And then I could make like a longer one or a big, huge square one with four big squares or something like that. I might do that, and just because I think that that's sort of interesting as well.
Yeah.
Because I know on Legacy Knits, Sue, she knit, I think hers were about this size. So that's 1, 2, 3. That's 16 squares. I think she did 16, and then she did a border around it.
Mm-hmm.
One for every month of this year is what she's doing.
And then so she's going to each
month has 16 squares.
Oh, that's such a good
idea.
And then
she does a border, and then she's going to put it all together in one blanket.
Like, that's kind of a neat idea. You know what's cool about that is it keeps you on track. You're like, I only have to do 16 squares this month. Because they do knit up really quickly.
They do.
But then when you're just like, oh, I just need to do 16. And face it, that's like two squares.
A square every other day. Pretty much.
So,
yeah.
I mean, that seems really doable.
Yeah.
And you can, and then you'll have your square done.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next month you can, oh, that's such a cool idea.
It is a cool idea.
So now
I'm putting my little elephant, which I'm using as my progress keeper, on the purple. And so that's where I'll see, next time I show you, I'll show that it'll be from there.
Yeah.
So, Yeah, there's that I'm working on, and then there's two other smaller projects which I have to have done for November. This is the spiral staircase shawl that I'm doing, so I've got this much done. I don't think I've done too much since the last
that's
time.
That's such pretty it variegated is.
That's,
yarn.
That's from the Picasso Moon. Picasso's Moon. It's merino alpaca blend, I believe.
Oh, I was going to say, it's so soft. And look at the little hits of yellow in there.
Yeah.
You've got these sort of really, not dark, but these kind of intense jewel tones with grays and a little bit of white, and then that little hit of the yellow right in through there.
I know, so
just
pretty.
Just to give it a funny little bright splash.
So I'll do, so I'm making that one. And, like, this is the other one that I made, and this is, I dyed this one myself as well. Mm-hmm. This is one of the ones that when we had a yarn enabler and yarn therapist that had a dye night, I did this one.
Yeah,
this was a DK, it's an MCN DK.
Yeah.
Which I love.
So that's what this is going to finish up like, which is going to be awesome.
I do. And then the one other one, I'm doing this it's very small, it's lace weight. This is Turtle Pearls Baby Boo. It's bamboo and merino. And I am doing the conundrum scarf. So this is it. And I'm just doing it in this. I love it. And the striping changes now that it's getting larger. It changes. It's going to change as it goes.
Because when it's a ball, you don't necessarily know that it's going to be
and this
striped.
This ball was huge. This is actually the third thing I'm making from this ball.
Oh, because it's lace. That's why.
Yeah.
See how pretty
that is? I made a Here Be Water Dragon scarf, which was really long.
Mm-hmm.
And then I made the Jamie Shawlette, that little one as well. And that was the first time I had done a cast on like 200 stitches type shawl or shawlette.
Mm-hmm.
So... So that's basically what I'm working on right now.
Yeah.
I'm dying to get the socks started for my husband, though, and I'm just trying to figure it because it's such a thick yarn.
Mm-hmm.
It's a 6-ply.
Okay.
But so what I'm thinking, I think I might do the blueberry waffle because it's supposed to be done in a DK.
Oh, okay.
And
that's great.
Yeah. So I think it actually, it's a Regia 6-ply. And I think that's what I'm going to use.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to use that pattern because it does call for the DK, and I've got the larger needles now.
Yeah.
Yay! Yes. That's that. We have no stash busting this week because we kind of have acquisitions. Just a few.
Just a few. Yes.
But I will go into pod love as well. Right now, I've only listened to one new podcast, and it is Knit Nicks, and her name is Carla, and she is from Calgary.
Oh, that's cool.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And I watched her today. Anyways, talking about our trip.
Yeah, I think that's we need to get,
we need to get started. We've got so much stuff.
we went crazy when we were down in the U.S., so we left. I had stayed over at Sheila's on Sunday night, and then we left directly from her place on Monday morning, and we left on time.
About 9 o'clock,
which is what we had planned, which is... really unusual for us.
Earlier than if we were going with my husband.
Yeah, well...
we'd be on the road by 6:30 in the morning.
Yeah.
It's like, no.
Well, and neither of us are really morning people, but we figured, okay, we'll go for 9, and we actually were on the road like 5:02, so we consider that
woo-hoo!
Fantastic. So, as I said, Sheila did all the driving.
Yes.
And we headed along, and you have that sense of adventure and excitement as you're heading off.
Mm-hmm.
Got our Tims to
hit
the road.
By Kingston, I think it was.
Yeah. And across the border, and
we had no trouble crossing the border.
None at all.
We didn't pull an Amanda and start going bomb, 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 bomb.
We just sailed through. There was about a 5-minute wait. There were about 3 or 4
Once
cars,
I got into the right lane.
Having never done it before, there are these
easy
pass lanes where I guess if you travel frequently, you get this easy pass and you can
special card.
So of course we don't have that, and we're both wearing glasses, so we're like can we go in this lane? I don't know. And so anyway, as we get closer, we realize...
The road signs were bad.
Yeah. So anyway, we managed to get into the right lane eventually. Somebody was nice and let us in.
Yeah.
But there were about...
then we looked behind us and there was like other people doing the exact same thing. So we weren't alone.
Yeah. but yeah, we got over the border very quickly and then headed south. And the drive was gorgeous.
Oh, beautiful weather for driving.
Weather-wise was beautiful. The scenery was gorgeous. And of course, especially in that northern part of New York State, hardly any traffic.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
So I was amazed at how little traffic we went to got near larger areas. There was like almost no traffic. It was amazing.
It was a fantastic drive.
And one of our concerns though was because, the hurricane.
Yes. So we were a little concerned, but you know, we'd been keeping an eye on the weather and we figured that we would probably be okay.
Yeah.
And so Monday was a long drive day. It was really long.
Yeah.
So, but we were good because we, did stops every few hours just to stretch our legs, go to the bathroom, maybe get some water or something. And, so we managed to, it was only in the last hour as we headed into Rhode Island, that we actually got a little, we were getting near our hotel.
And we had rain.
We got some rain from the hurricane. But it was dark and we were still trying to figure out where we were still on the highway or the interstate or whatever.
Whatever it was, the highway. Yeah.
And, so it was a little concerning, but you know, we were both really paying attention and we managed to get, unfortunately the hotel that we picked was like, once you get off the highway, it was like, boom, right there.
Yeah.
So, so it was good. And so then you get to relax.
And it had a pool and a hot tub. So we went for
just to kind of relax the day off ourselves.
Yes.
And,
yes.
Yeah. So, so it was the next day, the Tuesday that we actually headed into,
headed to Love to Knit.
To
see the yarn shop girls.
Yes. So that was our first stop. Mm-hmm. We were really excited to see because they do their podcasts directly from their shop. And so you can always see all the lovely things behind them, all the nice yarn. And it just looked like a really
nice... Which I
nice...
will be adding to this afterwards.
So we were really thrilled to be able to go there. And
it was so nice.
Yeah. So we walked in and...
Marissa and
Gail were all there and so excited to meet us. They greeted us, hugged us.
They were just so welcoming.
Yeah.
And they had a little surprise for us. Yes. And they had Janelle from Quarry Fibers was there that day.
It was
so nice. She's such a nice lady. I feel bad we didn't get a picture with her, though.
I know. So, it was great. We met Janelle.
Mm-hmm.
She was showing us actually some... yarns, some brand new yarns that
she was doing that 13 stripe yarn.
Yeah, there was
My goodness, she was knitting a sock with this, and it's got 13 stripe repeats.
And it was beautiful.
It was gorgeous. Yep.
And then some of her other new yarns they showed us. So I'm actually just going to get started and show you.
Yes.
Because, as I said, we did go a little bit crazy. Excuse me as I go off the screen here. So, I want to show you first what we got from Janelle from Quarry Fibers because she's dyed these gradients and just look at the colors in this. I want to try and get it so that it doesn't get the reflection. I haven't taken it out of this gorgeous.
It's very blue in that, but it's actually more of a tealy green.
It's called Squall. And you can see that it's... merino silk cashmere.
It's so soft.
I have opened it because I, you know, actually opened it in the shop and that was when I said, okay, I have to have this because
it's so soft.
Holy cow, is it soft. And look at these little minis.
But it works out that there's 500
yards, I think.
Each total. Yeah.
So isn't that gorgeous? Oh my gosh. And it's just incredible.
There's 10 minis, and each of them is 50 yards.
So, yeah, it's, and so this was, it's funny because when I went in there, I'll try and show a photo of we did take a photo with the ladies, with the yarn shop girls. And when I did go, when I was in there, my t-shirt that I was wearing was about that color. So it was sort of like meant to be.
Yes.
But she did have another set of gradients that were so beautiful as well. Mm-hmm. That was more of a cranberry, a series of sort of leading to cranberry. Oh my gosh, just beautiful. I don't know how you do a gradient, but hers are so, they're just
gorgeous.
Just look at how close together that is and how...
You can, like, it's really hard to see on the screen, but you can see each one, it's so subtle, the change.
Yeah, and when I was there, I also decided, I happened to find this other...
I absolutely love that.
Gorgeous, gorgeous one, also from Query. There we go. And you can see it is called, it's a worsted weight, superwash merino, and it's called Zest. And you can see it's this sort of the natural color with these beautiful speckles of orange.
Yeah, it sort of has a peach undertone to the natural color.
Yeah,
the very slightest bit of change. And then the
so you
speckle,
can see, oh my gosh, the speckle, and it's really, really soft. It's just like squishy. Because it's, as I said, because it's worsted weight, it's a really nice, oh, I think I'm going to make there's approximately 327 yards. It's 150 grams gain. So I'm going to make something.
Oh, it's so nice. It is so soft.
It's so squishy.
Like, ooh, yarn beard.
So squishy.
Ooh.
Nice. And then the other, okay, so I, like I said, I went really crazy. So I bought also, I've seen this and often wanted to get it, and so I decided to really go for it. So I got this Anzula squishy. There we go. Oops, there we go. Squishy.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that pretty? So this colorway is called Bark. And it is a sort of...
It's an 80-10-10, so 80 merino, 10 cashmere, 10 nylon. So soft. It is like so soft.
It's just
like 385 yards, approximately.
Oh my God. I don't know,
soft.
But it's just...
I know.
Oh my God. So nice, so nice. Anyway, I've wanted to try Anzula for a while.
I've heard really good things about it.
Yeah, so I just thought this is really pretty. It's got some really pretty, like you can see the tonals. I love a nice tonal. And there's even a little bit of orange, a little bit of a natural sort of shining through.
Yeah.
Honey colors. I think of it as honey. And, oh, anyway, so I splurged and got myself.
And the shop was just so amazing. There was a full table of women knitting there, and they brought us back. Hi, these ladies came all the way from Canada, and it was somebody's birthday, and they wanted to give us cake, and they were just so,
it was so nice.
Welcoming. All the shops we went to all had these huge tables. Basically in the center of the shop, and people just came and went and could knit and they would, it was just, they were always so warm, welcoming and inviting, so open and airy and just lovely shops.
Really lovely. And then I wanted to show this. This I had no intention of getting, but I saw the pattern on the bag, so I got myself this bag. And again, they were telling me that a local woman, someone who actually comes in and knits, she also sews. And she started making her own project bags and then expanded to selling her bags at Love to Knit. And so her name, there's the tag. Dee Dee Stuff.
That's what she calls it.
And this is her large caddy yarn
basket.
And you can see why I liked it.
It's got martini glasses. And Margaret likes a good martini.
This one here,
that's hers.
A dirty martini. That's for me. So, but you know, and it's got the pink polka dots, which I adore, and just a little
snap. But all around the outside is little wee pockets,
little teeny pockets.
So you can put all your little bits and pieces and just little things around the outside.
Yeah, isn't that a great idea?
Yeah.
So, and again, the
snap handle
that goes on here. So anyway, she had a bunch of different sizes and choices. I think there were some Halloween type ones in there.
Mm-hmm.
So, which was awesome. So
yes,
very, anyway, that one was really fun. And then I think the last thing I got was
that pattern.
Again, I think she said it was a local fellow
that designed it.
So it is a purchased one. So I'll just show you that. Garter Waves hat, a man made by, I guess it's John or Johnny, exclusive design. Isn't that cute? I love making hats. I started making hats last year and I just love, like, because I can kind of whip right through them. And I thought that was kind of a fun looking one right there. Mm-hmm. And it's nice finding ones that are sort of unisex or that a man might want, because we do have our shop, and I don't know if I haven't contacted him to see if we could actually sell his, but I always assume it's going to be women who are shopping on Etsy, but there may be some men, and even if it is women who are shopping, they may prefer to shop for the man in their life.
Yes.
Or men, brothers, husbands, whoever. Mm-hmm. So anyway, it's fun to have a nice hat pattern. I always like looking for hat patterns. So that was my other one.
Yep. And we both got, I'll show you because I'm doing it.
Yeah,
we all both got a sock ruler.
Yes, I have been inspired by Mary Beth of the Crafty Toads, because she, like me, was not really a sock knitter.
No.
And she has started, and I feel like...
And I feel I need to do that, because I know I've made some,
and I have to step up to the plate and learn.
Yes. Well, anyway, so we both got that, but then I also got... this is what I got from Quarry Fibers.
Look how beautiful
Babe.
That is. Babe like the pig.
Yes. But it has like... red, and it's dark and pink, and it's almost like a purple.
I was gonna say it's like a brownie purpley,
like
color,
a purple, like just oh my god, it's just gorgeous, just absolutely gorgeous.
And what is that? Oh, it's merino
nylon. It says Stellina, but I don't see too much. There's a little bit of sparkle, but I don't see, it's not as much sparkle as I've seen in some other socks.
It's, I think it's only 5%.
Yeah, it is,
so that might be why. But it's, that's really fun.
Yes, it is. It looked, I just love that. I kind of like pink. being the mother of all boys, I try to infuse pink into my life as much as I can. So, and then I got a gradient kit from Quarry as well. But mine came this way. This is her grayscale. And these are all the grays.
Oh, so pretty.
I know.
She did such a great job with her gradients.
Yes.
She really does.
Yeah. So, yeah, these are 25 grams each and 100 yards. And I've got 2, 4, 6, 8. So.
Wow. That's a lot.
So 850 yards. Mm-hmm. So I can have one hell of a shawl out of this.
Yeah, I think so.
So, but yes, these are gorgeous, because I've always thought, I want to get a gradient. I want a gradient. Mm-hmm. And that's what I got. So
that's a really nice neutral as well. And,
and
as I said, her gradient, she's done a really great job.
She just
on her
does
gradients.
An amazing job on her gradients.
Mm-hmm.
So that was Rhode Island.
Yes. And, you know, before we left, fortunately, we did manage to get some photos with the yarn shop girls. And again, so just take this opportunity to say thank you so much for welcoming us into your shop, and we'll have to find an excuse to come and visit again.
Yes. Next time we may have a few more people with us.
Yes, yes. We might have to do a party bus.
Yes. I know.
So
a couple of vans and away we go.
Yes.
Yes.
So then that night after we left Love to Knit, we actually, before, we went to this awesome place. What was it called? Dave's Marketplace or Dave's Market or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of like near here we have something called Farm Boy, a grocery store, and it sells a lot of organic and fresh food.
And as local as they can.
And as local as possible. Yeah. And so this was very much the same.
Yes.
Just a lovely, clean shop and a lot of organic. We picked up, because we just like to munch, so we thought, well, we'll pick up a few things.
We're
and we
grazers.
Picked up some olives in like a flavored oil and with some feta cheese. We picked up an amazing salad.
That was very
great.
Good.
Greens with some, was it some nuts? And
I think it had some nuts, maybe a bit of feta, but definitely some cranberries in there too.
So we had that. It was delicious. And then we got some fairly local cheese as well, a nice sharp cheddar.
14 months aged.
Yes.
Oh, it was like so good.
So good.
And then we walked next door and got a bottle of wine.
Yes. So we put all that in and then we drove along to New Jersey, mm-hmm. went to our hotel there. And discovered it did
New
not...
New Jersey, you cannot make left-hand turns.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes, that was interesting.
Oh, that was... We sort of went around in circles a couple times until we figured it, found our way, and got into the hotel.
Yeah. So, and then when we got in, that was a place that didn't have a pool,
no
right?
No pool.
So there was no pool. So we thought, okay, it's jammies and wine. So
that's what we did. Jammies and wine. Yep.
And we split the salad. That was our dinner. And we just munched on some of the olives in the hotel room. I mean, it was really, really nice. Slept very well that night.
Yes, we did. It was very nice.
We didn't have a lot to drink, though.
No.
And then the next day, we headed out to Toad Hollow.
And meet Mary Beth and Helen.
The Crafty Toads mm-hmm. in their shop, Toad Hollow. And again, welcomed, so warm. It was like meeting old friends.
Yes.
And hugs and such.
And we got to meet Drusilla and Sprite, the dogs. Oh my God, they were adorable. Yeah. They were absolutely adorable.
Yeah, they were just as excited as we were.
They were. And they're lined up, and I'm rubbing their belly. Yeah. They're just like right out there. Yeah. It was so nice.
Yeah.
But they gave us a little present.
They gave us a present. Oh my gosh, we were thrilled to bits. Look at
Margaret and Shelagh's Great Yarn Crawl 2016, and they had the Toad Hollow.
Yeah.
Oh my God, we were so happy to have that. That was so sweet.
They made this for us, and you know, we also knew that they were preparing. Upcoming weekend, they were preparing a whole bunch of bags because they were going to be attending the New Jersey Sheep and Wool Festival. And they would be selling their project bags there. So for them to actually take the time and make something special like this for us, it was so touching, so sweet of them to do
this. Yeah, it was.
So we were delighted. And then, after chatting with them a little bit, is that when we did we tried to do a podcast?
We tried to do that and it got erased.
It got, I
or
don't know.
Lost it, somewhere.
It got lost in the ether somewhere. But
yes.
Regardless, we had a really fun time. Four of us kind of crowding around trying to
talk. We're sitting all like this.
Yes.
It was great because when we met them, it was really like meeting some like an old friend that you just hadn't seen
for
years.
A while. Yeah,
yeah.
You just sort of picked up. And,
yes.
Oh, it was so great, so much fun. So they got back to work, and we headed down to their local yarn shop, which is
Chelsea Yarns.
And of course, we went a little bit crazy there too.
Mm-hmm. So, and Christina, Chelsea Yarns,
the nicest lady, so sweet. And she had, I don't know if he was just an assistant or if he was...
He goes there all the time and knows the stuff.
But Vincent was there, and he was the nicest guy.
Absolute sweetheart.
Knitting some, like, amazing stuff.
Oh my gosh. Yeah.
And again, she had some really nice yarns. Mm-hmm. And because, she carries locally dyed yarns as well. So we'd seen, Mary Beth and Helen had talked about this, but marionated yarns. So what did you get? Two.
I got two.
And I got one. Mine is called Drizzly Day, and it's Scrumptious HT Fingering Weight.
Yeah, so, that's my green one's that.
So that's 80% superwash merino, 10% cashmere, 10% nylon, and it's about 400 yards.
Yeah.
And it's just a Drizzly Day is a nice, it looks much lighter than it actually mm-hmm. is. But it's a medium gray, lovely soft gray. I've been thinking about a while back, I got some yarn of Amanda's that she had dyed mm-hmm. for Mrs. Brown bags, and it was a kit, like it came with the project mm-hmm. bag and the yarn. And it's a really pretty pastel gradient that she's done, and I thought I'd really like to do something with gray somehow with it. So I thought, oh, I'm going to get some of this gray. So I've been looking for a really gray. That gray's perfect.
She ran out to the car and got the bag.
I didn't have the yarn with me, but I have the project bag. And I thought, yeah, this is going to work really well. So I'm really excited to try this.
She didn't want it too pale.
No, because the pastels, it needed to kind of be able to stand out against that.
So my marionated yarn, this is her Harley fingering weight, which is... Okay.
Hello again.
Hello again. I accidentally touched the button.
Yeah.
So this Harley is 55% superwash merino, 20% kid mohair, and 25% nylon. Well, that doesn't... Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. And, you can kind of see the color, a little bit of a halo. Yes. If you bring it a bit closer, you can see a little bit of a halo to it.
Oh, yeah. It's got quite the halo.
So that'll be the mohair.
Yes. This is called Sandstorm, and so it's sort of a... taupey gray with brown hints of brown. Yes. You can see that in there.
Mm-hmm. It's just really pretty.
It's really, really nice. It's a nice neutral.
Nice and beautiful tonals.
Yes, very nice. And this one is the Scrumptious HT. So that's her MCN.
Mm-hmm.
And this colorway is called All of This, All of That. And it's olive, as in the olives that you eat. And it has like, it's mostly greens, but it's got browns. There's a brown undertone to it. And not that, I don't know if you can see, but there's little, it's got nice darks. Mm-hmm. I love the tones and the twists of the yarn and that. There's a bit of brown on there. Like you can see that there. So really looking forward to making something with that. Mm-hmm. You just see colors and you just think, I need that.
Yep. Yeah, that's gorgeous.
Yes. And then Chelsea was Christina, an absolute sweetheart.
Mm-hmm.
She dyes yarn.
She does dye yarn.
And she was sweet. She goes, she gave us a skein each.
Yeah, of her own hand-dyed yarn, which thoroughly unexpected and incredibly totally sweet and kind.
Yes. So this is, I got this mini package. Of all of these minis.
Oh, those are gorgeous. So are they going to go in your blanket? In your cozy memories?
I do not know what I'm going to do. I might use them for toes and cuffs and things like that.
That would be awesome.
And this is her Luxe hand dyed.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So. And it is merino, superwash merino and nylon. And each of the, it says 93 yards. I don't know if that's total or, I think that's per skein. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. I've got 5 skeins there.
Yeah.
And this is her summer mini mania, she called it. So like, just the colors are just amazing.
Yeah.
I just love them.
Yes.
So that was so sweet of her.
It was sweet. And I also have some of her Luxe yarn, but look at these colors.
That is fabulous.
Isn't that amazing? I just, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh.
She called it confetti.
Confetti. Isn't that the perfect name for this? It's just so nice. Mm-hmm. Now, although this is also her Luxe, it is BFL and...
nylon. Superwash BFL and nylon.
Yeah. And...
460 yards.
Isn't that just, oh my gosh.
It's gorgeous. It's just so nice.
Oh my God. And I quite like, you made something with BFL before, I think. Was it a sock or something? But it's quite soft. It's really, really soft.
No, I haven't.
Oh my gosh, I just love every color in here. Yes.
So,
but I have no idea what I'm going to do with it, but oh my gosh.
Yes. And she had some really adorable stitch markers.
Mm-hmm.
So, and progress keepers. Oh, it's so hard to do this in the bag because I want them to sit the right way. Yeah. I have a thing for elephants, and she had elephants.
Yes, they were so pretty.
So that is them.
Oh, and aren't they cute?
Yes, I know. It's like they're carved out of something, like a stone or a wood or something like that. But yes, they're just absolutely adorable. So I love that. So I picked it. I bought those.
Yeah, and I got a little pair of hearts. Little pink hearts, like rose quartz.
Beautiful.
Yeah, absolutely down beautiful. Here. Yeah, aren't they gorgeous? Yes. Just so sweet.
And she
just
has
sweet.
Stitch markers and, of her store.
Yeah, a little, is it a stitch marker?
It's a star, it is a stitch marker, yeah. So,
yay!
Yay,
so got we got those.
Yes.
Yes, and I got one as well. She threw them in, which is just so nice.
That was so nice.
So that was a lot of fun.
Oh, so
and then
much
that
fun.
Night, we went out. We met with Mary Beth and Helen again.
Yes.
And we went out for their trivia night.
At their local pub.
At a local pub.
Oh my gosh, we had so much fun.
We had so much fun.
Got to meet some of their friends.
Some of her friends, Erin. I can't remember the others' names, unfortunately.
No,
you know what it's like when you're in a pub and you can't really hear people very well.
Oh, it was very loud. It was loud, but we had so much fun. And our team came in first. We were number one.
Yes.
So it's like, yay!
Yep. So, we had a great time. And then we met them the next morning for breakfast.
Oh, that was
at a diner, just like where they are, where their shop is and where they live.
In Keyport.
In Keyport in New Jersey. It's a smallish seaside town. Beautiful waterfront. They took us for a little stroll along the waterfront just so we could see it. They pointed out, oh, Staten Island's over there. And it was a bit drizzly when we were out, but they were saying that, you know, when you look across on a clear day, you can see the Freedom Tower. It was quite amazing where they are. Beautifully kept along the waterfront. This particular diner that we met at for breakfast had been voted the best diner in New Jersey.
Number one diner in New Jersey. Yeah.
Yeah.
The food was so good.
Yeah.
It was called the
Broad Street Diner. Anybody's interested.
Yes. But it's very, very good.
Yeah.
And I had this Jersey Boy sandwich. It was sort of like a, what is it?
A
club sandwich, but they have what they call a pork roll.
Yes.
Which is sort of like a seasoned, or like seasoned as in flavoring seasoned ham.
Mm-hmm.
And that was on the bottom. And then it had like a fried egg with tomato and lettuce on the top half. Oh my God, it was like so good. they cut it in four. And I ate two of those pieces.
Well, yeah, two quarters, half.
Like a half of it for breakfast. And I took the other half with us and we
had it for dinner.
We had it for dinner that night. We had a microwave in our room. We just zapped it.
Yeah. And I had a Keyport bowl, which is essentially like your hash browns.
With everything mixed in.
And bacon, some sausage, and then an egg on top, like scrambled egg on top, and then covered in cheese. Melted over it.
It looked absolutely delicious.
It was in a bowl, and oh my gosh, it was so good. Mm-hmm. I couldn't finish mine either. I made a good attempt.
Yes. Yeah.
I was so stuffed.
They were so good. The food was just amazing.
Yeah.
Absolutely amazing.
I can see why it would be voted.
Yes. The food was phenomenal.
Because it was really good and it was clean and the staff was really friendly and it was just, it was a really nice place.
Yeah.
A really nice place. So,
yeah.
We were so delighted that that Helen and Mary Beth, kind of invited us into their lives for a few days, which was just so sweet of them to do.
And they have an invitation to come up here if they want to.
Yes.
So that would be great.
So, but we did eventually have to leave.
Yeah.
And so we headed north a bit, not too far.
No, it was about 45 minutes.
Yeah.
Half an hour, 45 minutes. We went to Westfield, New Jersey.
Yes.
And went to, I'm going to put the bag up.
Yeah.
Do You Knit?
Yes.
And Karen of Do You Knit?
Yes. We follow her on Instagram.
Yes, and one of her buddies is Stephen West.
Yes.
And also Stephen B.
Yeah.
And
the lady who does the hedgehog fibers.
Yes. Yes. And that was one of the main thing that we wanted, because hedgehog in Canada is very difficult to get. There are a few stores that carry it. But
often I don't have a huge selection.
She had if anybody follows us on Instagram, they would have seen the picture we took with Karen. All that entire wall was hedgehog fibers.
All those cubbies were filled. Single, sock,
but she also
DK.
And she also carries
I think she was telling us that pretty much everything she carries is by an indie dyer.
Yes.
And she has a really good eye for finding people who make unique yarns.
Yes.
And again, you know, it's a smallish shot, but really sweet. I loved
Oh, white like, and bright
with
and
with a big pink opening wall at the back, which yes. I of course loved.
And had we been there a couple days earlier on the Tuesday, she was telling us that Stephen West just decided to stop mm-hmm. by the shop, and he came and he was sitting there knitting.
Yeah.
And people are walking in the shop sort of going
oh,
like that's Stephen West sitting yes. there knitting. Yes. Yeah. So, yeah. So we were just a couple days later.
Yeah.
Oh, but well. Missed him, but that's okay. That's apparently okay. He's quite tall. But yeah. 6'3", I think she said.
Yeah. Yeah. So, but, you know, we did some damage there.
We did, definitely. Yeah. That was where I think I did the most damage.
Yeah, yeah I think you did. I'm yes. looking at your whole.
I know.
Do you want me to get started? Because
well, I got these. These are my hedgehog fibers. These three. Are the
so
three that I got.
Pretty.
This is a skinny single called Electric. And it's actually, that's really bright, but it's more of a navy.
It's sort of a cobalt.
Yeah, cobalt. It looks, yeah.
Yeah.
So that was that one. This one is called Bramble, which is, I really like it. It's browns
pretty.
And pinks. And it mm-hmm. just, oh, the colors are just.
Yeah,
I love it.
Yeah.
Love it.
I mean, if you like like Hedgehog is just known for their amazing speckles and
yeah.
colorways.
Yeah,
just awesome.
Yes, and this one is called Shiver, and it's got the blue with the pink.
Some yeah,
and like look
a
at that.
Tealy green.
Look
over
at that.
There. Yeah.
Oh, yes. There's some teal there. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Just absolutely gorgeous.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, so these two are not the single. These are just the sock. And the other one, this is a single.
Mm-hmm.
Then she carries yarn ink.
Oh. Yeah.
So I got this one. She calls this one Flamingo. And this is the sparkle, as you can see
a little bit of sparkle. Oh, my gosh. I love it.
So, yes, it's quite nice.
Yeah.
This one with a little bit of yellow and orange right here.
Yeah.
I'm terrible at holding this up to it.
I know.
Yeah. It's so
Go
awkward.
Go towards the green light.
Yes. Go towards the light. Then mm-hmm. she also carries Trey Liz.
Yeah. Okay. Show the name.
Yes.
I think we follow Trey Liz on Instagram. And this color is Surat.
Oh, yes.
If you are familiar with art, I think it would be sort of around the time, probably a little bit before Monet, but Surat was a painter in Paris who was known for a technique called stippling, which is lots of little dots of color to build shadow and shape.
Oh my God. And
so this is just beautiful.
The one thing she does,
at some point in her process, she
puts essential oils
in, and so it has this amazing scent.
Such fresh scent. Oh
yes.
My God. I
no,
absolutely
she's,
love it.
She's out of Greece, I think.
Yes, she is out of Greece.
Mm-hmm.
And the one last, and I got a pair of Chiaogus.
Mm.
So
Excellent.
Happy. Yes. And my last one, I had a thing for minis this trip, was from Blissful Knits. These are her classic minis, and there are 5 skeins and 88 yards per skein. They're superwash merino and nylon.
Oh, look how pretty those colors are.
Take that off. Open it.
Lid off.
There we go. There. Look at those colors.
Oh my gosh, they're so pretty. They're like ice cream. I don't know. They just make me think of summer.
Yes.
Just the whole thing about it just makes me think
Absolutely
of summer.
Absolutely love it. She doesn't have a name for them. It's just one of her classic mini skeins. And they had several boxes that had many different combinations.
Mm-hmm.
So,
mm-hmm.
yeah, I'm just like,
yeah, that it just, oh my gosh,
yes.
So much fun.
I know, it was so good. So that's where I did the most damage.
Yeah, and so of course I was the same.
Mm-hmm.
We were so excited to get some hedgehog, and so these are the colors. Like, I had seen some of these colors on Hedgehog's post, and I think I've seen people using some of these colors. Mm-hmm. This one here.
Love that one.
So this one is a skinny typewriter. Single, and it's in the colorway typewriter, which is mostly, you know, black flex, but there's a grayishness to
the... Like, look at that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then... I'm trying to see what this one is called.
That one is Salty Tales.
Salty Tales. Same thing. It is a skinny single from Hedgehog. And I'm looking... Look at the colors in that. So it's a almost charcoal base.
Yes. And so look at the teal.
And
the purple up there. And like there's the bit of the like... There's a purple there. And then there's the black and brown. And there's
like a brown up here. It's just like it's a phenomenal color, but it's subtle, but at the same time, it's really oh my gosh! Mm-hmm. So those two, and then I also got a sock weight, and I can't read that one either.
Film noir.
Oh, okay, it's over there.
Yeah.
That oh my gosh! Look how pretty that is. So I got that, and then of course. I'm not 100% sure what I'm going to do with it, I found this, again, at an Anzula yarn, and this colorway is called Chipmunk. And look how pretty that brown is, and you can see, like, little hits of grayish color mm-hmm. in there, but I was thinking of doing something with the two of them. I just thought that this would be...
Yes, that looks very good together.
Somehow these would look really awesome together. Yes.
We've been looking at a lot of
patterns that use two different yarns.
Lisa
Much has some really amazing, and she often uses two. Now she does her own yarn. Northbound NBK. Knitting in BK. Yeah. So she often has two colors.
Yes.
For hers. So I'm leaning towards doing something there.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I also got a yarn ink. Someone we follow online, I think she's actually Canadian.
Yes, she is.
And so this one is called Heart and Soul.
Absolutely pretty? Love it.
And I think there is a speckle in there. So the bottom part is mm-hmm. a lot of the natural. And then it's some of these gorgeous teals, and it leans out to the purples and the blues.
Yeah.
Let's pull that up a little bit there.
Oh, I know.
Oh,
just absolutely gorgeous. Just gorgeous.
Oh, my gosh. I love, like, if you're looking at it and you see the way her, oh, my gosh, look at that. It looks mm-hmm. like there's nothing at this end, and then it's got all this color here, but then it's just kind of this mash in the middle.
Oh.
It's beautiful. And there is all my, let's see if we can get that sparkle in there.
I can sort of see it. Hold it. Let me, give it to me. There we go.
Yeah.
Yes, you have to sort of let it move. You can see the sparkle and shimmer in there just a little bit.
Oh my gosh, I love this. All my colors. And then I also got a tray lid. Oh my gosh, it smells so amazing. So this one I think is also a single. 100% superwash merino sock weight.
Mm-hmm.
And it's called Mandala. As soon as I heard it was called Mandala, I thought I have to have it. It's an unusual combination of colors to my eye. But then that's why I'm not dying. Like I said, it's not something I think I would normally go for, but I think that's one of the things that I think is really neat because I need step away from.
Not even that. When you picture a mandala,
the multitude of colors.
The multitude of colors. That is it.
Yeah.
That is it when you think of it.
So it's amazing. I'm looking at some of the greens, turquoise. This is like a really... It's not showing up that way, but oh my gosh, it's actually a really bright, like a chartreuse.
Yeah. Yes, very
A brown.
Or I think it's the grocery girls call it like an acid green.
Yeah, this is more of an acid green.
Yes,
this is more of a chartreuse.
Yes,
gold.
And it's got the browns to gold to orange
and to, into the blues. Red. Oh my gosh, mm-hmm. it's amazing. So I had to get that.
And needles.
And I got some.
A pair of Knitter's Pride carbons.
Yes. So these are ones that I thought I might be able to do some, if I do double.
DP, do the magic loop.
Two at a time.
Yes.
In magic loop. So that's why I got those.
So from there, we came home. We drove partway up to New York to...
upstate New York. I can't remember the town name. Oh, my goodness. It's a ski town.
Yes. I want to say Colton or like Colton, no. Cochrane. I can't remember what it is, but it was north of... I can't even remember that. Anyway, where we stayed. Beautiful town.
It was north of Albany, wasn't it? Or was it... No.
Yes, anyway, I think so.
It was in upstate New York, I guess, is how in you the describe mountains. It. In the mountainous area. And again, it was a bit drizzly as we were arriving. Yeah. And this was the only hotel we didn't know. Every other hotel is basically we get off the highway and it's wasn't like a far. Block away.
Yeah. Where are we going? We're up and down and around. They were like all over the place. I was like, are we sure we're going the right way?
Yeah.
Then we came upon this little wee town and it was like, wow. Yeah. And it was beautiful. Yeah. It was a Best Western Plus, mm-hmm. apparently. And it had a nice pool, which was nice and warm compared to the other pool.
One. Yeah.
And a chandelier in the lobby. It was just beautiful. Yeah. Beautiful, beautiful.
It was hotel. A really lovely
It looked like
hotel.
It was fairly new, too.
Yeah. And it was in a ski town. So I can imagine in the winter it would be quite amazing to be there as well. So
The food, the breakfast was very good there for the continental breakfast. That was quite enjoyable. It was just lovely, absolutely lovely. Yeah. Really enjoyed it.
So we stayed there overnight, and then on the Friday we headed back to Canada.
Yeah,
drove up from there. It wasn't too bad, but no. Went up through again. It didn't take us long to get through. At customs, really quick, asked us only a couple of questions and off we went.
Yep.
And, then we stopped in
in Picton, Ontario at a store called Rosehaven Yarns. Which we saw her at the Knitter's Frolic.
Knitter's Frolic.
She does go to the Knitter's Frolic in Toronto, throughout the year. But we did go there.
Yeah.
And
so we've always wanted to go to her shop, and we've actually been talking about maybe just doing a day trip.
Because we can do that. Because it's only about 2 hours from my house.
Yeah. And so we thought, we could do a day trip and then, you know, go there and come back. But when we started talking about doing this, and the reason we started talking about doing this is I actually have been collecting air miles.
Yeah.
And I got this email saying, you know, you've got to use up your air miles before the end of the year.
Yes,
you have X amount to use up. So we used my air miles for all our hotels.
Yes.
So that was awesome.
Yeah.
So on the way back.
We were thinking of doing it on the way there, but we decided we'd do it on the way back.
Yeah. And so we stopped in and met Leslie. Who's the owner of Rosehaven, who also knits these amazing, she showed some of the shawls.
Oh my goodness.
She kind of reminds me a bit.
Dye as well? Does she dye
she
some?
Dyes.
She does dye some yarn
But
too.
She kind of reminds me in her the way that she likes to work with color and texture of a Stephen West.
Yes.
She doesn't knit like his style in any way.
No.
But her... her fearlessness when it comes to working with yarns, colors, textures is equivalent to his, I would say.
Yes.
And she's just so warm and welcoming when you get into her shop, too.
Yes, it was so nice.
So she carries some indie dyers.
Yes, she does.
But she also carries some sort of standard yarns as well. So there's a really nice selection there, which
it is.
I think probably really speaks well to her customer base.
Yes.
That would be my guess. Like there's just a really nice selection of things there.
Yes. So I got a pair of Chow Goose.
Excellent.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Have to try it. Everybody's talking about all
Everybody's
these needles.
Everybody's talking about these needles, so we wanted to try them.
So this is one of the indie dyers. Dying for the Color Fiber Works for all your fiber fun. So I got this one. It's a sock yarn. And it's just beautiful. It's sort of pale, minty green.
Minty green, but it's really got pretty.
These, ooh. Like, pops of color
ooh,
in it.
That's
like,
really
look
cool,
at
eh?
The green there. It's got these other, like, colors of green. So, like, it goes right there, sort of a tonal. It gets slightly darker, but yeah. Then it's got this teal, like, this dark teal mm-hmm. thrown in, and that, I call it frog green in there as well. Like, so look at that.
This is, Dyeing for yeah. Color Fiber Works.
Yep.
So show her card.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Awesome, awesome.
Yeah. So got that.
And your chow goos.
And my chow goos. And this is also Boho Knits.
Oh, yeah.
She's also a local dyer out in the Prince Edward County area.
Mm-hmm.
This is called Freckles. And it says each is unique, so each ball is as unique as your freckles are.
Yeah.
So that's sort of, it's almost like your hedgehog typewriter in a way.
Yeah.
With the, like a Dalmatian looking.
Mm-hmm.
Because this one is also called Freckles, and look at this one, and it's all colored like confetti, like a rainbow confetti cake.
Yeah. Oh, it's so pretty. Yeah, like I have that one called Confetti.
Yeah.
And it's a bit similar.
Well,
like it's nothing like it.
Yes.
But, and so this is the Ramble fingering weight.
Yes.
So it's superwash merino, 75% and 25% nylon.
Yeah, and there's 462 yards mm-hmm. in each of the skeins.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Nice.
Not bad. So, yep, that was, did damage there. And we found out, sorry for reaching off, that... she's involved in getting a Fiber Fest for 2017. It'll be the first one in the Prince Edward County area, Picton area. So, and she gave us a few of these because we're going to give these to some friends of ours who are into dyeing and things like that. So that's just what it's going to be. And I just thought that was very interesting. Mm-hmm. I got a whole bunch of those.
Yeah. And I also got chow goose. So I got the 40-inch size 1 US or 2.25 millimeter. Mine are the premium bamboo.
Mm-hmm.
And again, this is
the
mine
were two,
ones...
Yeah.
Yeah, see, it's because I'm a very loose knitter, so I thought if I tackle socks, I should probably go for smallish needles to keep them somewhat tight. So
yes.
that's what I got
yes.
there. And
This is the card. This is Leslie's business card.
Yes,
just so that you're aware.
Yeah, and so I got some of Leslie's hand-dyed yarn that she did herself. So
yeah.
She calls it Black Creek
Black
Yarn.
Creek Yarn,
and this is fingering weight, and the color is maple leaves, which is appropriate. And I am really, really drawn to this kind of like pinks and golds together. I find that to be such a gorgeous combination. So this is such a pretty...
Yes, and it's actually a lot more gold than what it's showing.
It's showing
very yellow. But it's more gold.
It's definitely
an autumn gold.
An autumn gold.
Pull it back and see if it changed, because sometimes when you pull it away
yeah.
sort of the color sort of...
Yeah, now it looks more gold now, I guess.
Yes.
But not as rich.
No.
Anyway, it's stunning. So this is her, as I said, it's her Black Creek Yarns. There we go.
Right there. Go straight forward. Make it a little. There.
Yeah. So, so that's maple leaf, and that's, you can see, Leslie
mm-hmm.
Rosehaven yarn.
Yeah.
So, and it's very soft and squishy. Oh my gosh, it's soft and squishy.
Yeah. And that's,
so that was that.
Yes.
So, I had said when we got back, I should just stay over at her place because, we were going to
Saturday
was
the
Kitchener Waterloo Knitters, our fiber
Knitters Festival or something like that. Yes.
So this is something that happens every year in September. Mm-hmm. And I think this is the third one we've been to.
Yes, it is.
We tend to go with, often we go with
ladies, women from the
knitting circle. And so this time we just had Nancy with us, mm-hmm. which was awesome.
Yes.
Because Amanda and Jennifer actually had a table there, so they were selling their own hand-dyed
yarn. Amanda is the yarn enabler, and Jen is the yarn therapist. So they've been busy for the last month or so, dying like crazy.
So, and then Christina, the cozy knitter, and Shauna, who is she, so you say
on Instagram,
they were there to support them.
Well, Shauna makes project bags. And so she was also selling some of her project bags.
So,
but on the way there, we stopped off so Margaret could drop.
Oh, that's right.
Drop off.
So I wanted to drop off all my stuff on the way because I live on the way.
Yes.
Shelagh is quite far east of Toronto, about 45 minutes.
Yes, I'm east of Oshawa, about 10 minutes east of Oshawa.
And then I live right on the border to Toronto, and then we're going to Kitchener and Waterloo, which is west
the other side of Toronto.
So we dropped off all my stuff, and I thought, well, I'll just check to see.
In between shopping at the wool stores,
we went online.
Instagram is really bad.
Yes.
And we somehow came across,
I think I heard about her from another podcast.
Yes.
It might have been the Grocery Girls.
Mary.
So I saw this package, and I had completely forgotten that we had done this, but I saw this package, and then as soon as I saw it, I was like, oh my gosh. So it was so great. She sent this nice card for us, and is it May or Mary? I know you wouldn't know this, but the piece and the piece symbol here, that's really precious for us because our sister Irene, her name actually means peace.
Yes.
So she collected a lot of peace signs and, you know, things with the word peace on it and stuff. Yes. So that was really sweet. Like, that was the first thing I noticed.
I'm thinking of getting a tattoo on my wrist with a peace sign.
Yeah.
For her.
So she said, hi, ladies. Thank you so much for your order and support. I do hope you like my bags. So I, first of all, we'll show you what we ordered.
That
was Sheila's.
Mine! Flamingos! I love flamingos!
So this is, it's artisan bag.
Yes. And I ordered this little sock keychain. It's a sock blocker though, because she sent a pattern for making little mini socks, and I've already made one.
Oh my gosh, that's so cute. Let me see. Oh, look how that is so cute.
And she sent some yarn to go with it. So, and we're back.
So, Shelagh just finished showing you the really lovely flamingo project bag that she had ordered from mm-hmm. Artisan Bags.
Mary.
And I ordered another project bag. This one, I just love this because it's perfume bottles. I have collected a few perfume bottles over the years. I love Lalique and different blown and wound glass. So I have fallen madly in love with this one. Mm-hmm. And it's pink.
It's so her.
It's very much me. And then look at the gorgeous polka dots, mm-hmm. which I love, love, love. So, and then it's got this amazing toggle on here with a nice wrist strap. It's absolutely perfect. So mm-hmm. I can't wait. I've got a couple of projects I think I'm probably going to use in here. And it came, same as with Sheila's, it came with a little yarn. Hedgehog Fiber, she's named it Hedgehog Fibers.
It's an Erin Wake.
An Erin Wake birthday cake is the colorway. So I can make a little sock to go along with that using the sock blocker, just like that one. So we are so delighted. And then yes, she...
and it had a, and there's a progress keeper.
Yes.
And we got a progress keeper. Little, Mine's a little heart.
Yeah, that's what mine is. Nice little heart. See? Very sweet.
Yes.
And
she was very kind.
Kind.
Look at
kind,
this.
Kind.
Sent us one for a giveaway. And it comes with your little bit of yarn as well.
A little bit of yarn and a little candy. And we also
have a giveaway as well.
Yes.
It might go together. It might go separate. We haven't decided what we're going to do yet. So
we've got some stuff for giveaway. We're really excited about that.
I know.
And then, that was what we found on our way to the KW Knitters Fair.
Then.
And of course, when we got there, we were still in the buying frenzy that yarn fumes tends to fuel. So.
Yes. So I went to, I think our first stop was Zigzag Stitches.
We've had things from her before, and we really like her.
Our little DPN cozy.
Yes.
So I like this one. I love these. The socks, I think that is like, they're just adorable.
It's absolutely really adorable.
So I got that and some stitch markers. This one's a little teapot and ball of yarn with the needles. And then this one is some little mittens and a little sheep.
And a sheep. Oh my gosh, it's so adorable.
So, and then we got Studio Loo. These are, we've been buying from her, the pink from this color pink in my Pure Joy shawl, the pink.
The pink Lady
Scuffle.
Was
Studio Loo. And then I have this one, and it's called Peking Rainbow, which I really, really like. It's got the nice twist of color.
It's really sweet.
And gray. Absolutely love it.
Yeah.
Peking.
So it's peeking out from the gray skies.
Peking Rainbow.
And then it's got all the perfect rainbow colors.
Oh, I've got a rough idea of a shawl that I'm thinking of doing it for, but I'm not 100% sure right now if I'll use it with that. But it's like we're thinking about getting that Waiting for Rain pattern. I thought that'd be neat, especially if it worked out that I could get the rainbow one where the lace was. I think that would be really
cool. That would be cool, but it might be hard to make sure that
might
that
be hard
happened.
To, yes, for sure. And then we had to go visit our friends, Jen and Amanda.
Yes.
And Amanda is the yarn enabler, and Jen is the yarn therapist. And this is the first time they had their booth. So I bought this lovely skein.
Oh, so pretty.
Yes. Teacup Reading is what it's called.
Yeah. Let's bring it up a little bit higher, too.
That look pink at the pink and the brown. Just, I love that color combination.
Mm-hmm.
It is just...
I love pink and brown. I think it's such
just
a nice
beautiful
combination.
Like, it just goes right through.
Mm-hmm.
Eh? Like, just...
love
that.
Oh, it's so pretty. Like a chocolate chip.
Yes. Something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then I stopped at Bling Your String.
Yes, you got something from her before, a project bag, I think.
I did. I have this.
Oh, a little Notions. Oh, the mermaid one.
Pouch, my little Notions pouch, and this project bag.
Oh my God, the little monkeys. You see they're all little monkeys
and
on
I,
there.
I bought that at, I think it was at the Knitter's Fair.
At the Frolic.
Anyways. She was at the KW, and I bought this fabulous sock blank.
Oh, my God,
painted
that's so gorgeous.
Painted sock blank.
Look how beautiful that is. Oh, you know what it makes me think of is, you know when you look at, you know when you
Rorschach?
Do like a, yeah, or a lie detector test, and it kind of goes,
yeah,
zigzaggy like
almost
that?
Almost like a Rorschach
or
test.
Or a heartbeat, like if you look at it that way, it looks like a heartbeat.
Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
The way the paint goes. Or, it is kind of Rorschach-y.
Yeah.
Now, she's, her name is Erin, but she goes by Serafina BYS, like Bling Your String. And
there's her card.
Mm-hmm.
And this is this color, obviously. Fancy Pants is the color.
I love that.
So, absolutely love that. I can't wait to use that in something.
It's going
to
look so cool. One of the things that we always comment on is when we look at sock blanks and then we see how people, how they knit up, it just, you don't really know what you're going to get until you start knitting. So, it's always kind of a fun knit, a fun surprise.
Yes. So, but the last one I stopped at was the Blue Brick.
Yeah.
She has some yarns. But I did not get any yarn from her. I got this
Berry Vanilla. And it's
oh, it smells wonderful. It's a wool conditioner for cleansing and protection made with shea butter and lanolin oil. Mm-hmm. Because they were saying that when wool is being processed, they remove all the lanolin. Yes. That's why it sort of gets scratchy. So they've added it back in and it smells like wonderful.
It's really, really
it's
nice.
It's so, so heavenly.
And she actually makes like a hand cream. It's really rich. You only need a teensy bit, but it's got that same lovely scent.
Yes.
And one of our friends, Nancy, who went with us, she actually got the hand cream.
She got the hand cream, and she actually dyed a yarn to go with this in these colors. Yeah. In that sort of creamy color, but with the purple, and the gradient purple, the pink.
Mm-hmm. Yes. She's really talented, that lady.
She's really talented. Yeah. But so, it was just so, so neat.
So that's what Shelagh got.
Yeah.
And I was the same. As she said, we went to Zigzag, and I bought two with the thought that one will be for a giveaway at some point in the future, but I haven't decided which because I really like both of these. I bought a DPN case. I got two, actually. So this one I thought was so, so cute. I thought it would go with everything anybody is working on. And the inside...
So cute.
Again, with the polka dots. And yes. I love there's a color in there that somebody's going to love. There's just so many colors. And then this one here, again, really cute little stitch or DPN holder. And this one has the, I'll hold it the other way inside. So we can see what it says. But that's from Zigzag with the green with the polka dots.
I love that. That's so cute.
That's what I mean. I can't decide which one I like because they're both so cute. And on this side, you can see it's got the one sheep that's, it's not quite a black sheep, but it is a little bit darker than all the others. Yeah. And then down here, you can see the little blue rubber ducky.
And then
you
have the flower on the other side.
Yeah, and the flower. So, like, so one of these is going to be part of a giveaway at some point in the future, and I just it's going to be eeny meeny miny mo because I really like both of these.
Yeah. Well, Bling Your String also gave us one.
Mm-hmm.
This is a needle cozy as well, and this one actually has a little little clip on the inside. You know, some of you can clip it in. Oh. Some of the bags have little things inside, right. So you can clip it. Yeah. So that's that one. But I had also I also went to this one vendor, at the micro market called My Needle Crafts.
That's Cheryl.
And I got a bunch of these that I'm going to put in when we have a giveaway. We'll put these in with each of them for a giveaway. Nice little Canadian maple leaf progress keeper.
Mm-hmm.
So that's it. I forgot to put those.
Yeah. And so then I also from Zigzag, I like Shelagh, I got this because I've been eyeing one of these. So I got myself a nice little progress keeper
with the ball of wool and needles
just because I just love that. Yeah. And then we went to Studio Loo, as Shelagh said, and I got her tiptoe sock yarn. Hand-painted yarn, and it's 80-20 blend of superfine merino and durable nylon. So I got this one called Journey of the Dragon, which I really, really... Look at the colors in that. And it's got this really pretty...
And that's actually like purple? That's not blue. It's turning up very blue there, but if you turn it this way a little bit, I don't know, see right here? That is like so purple.
Yeah, it's very purple and green. This right here is sort of pinkish. Yes. And then it's got like the turquoise flecks throughout. Yeah.
I don't know. There was something about this that just grabbed me. I just loved it. There's a kind of a tweed effect, the way that
the speckles work. Yes, it looks...
And then I think those sort of heathery, natural-looking colors, earth tones, not really something I normally go for, but it's just so... I don't know. I just fell madly in love with it.
Does it show the purple?
It looks a little more purblish. Yeah, but it's still a little very more purplish. Blue.
Yeah, because it is. It's quite purple. It's very grape.
Yes.
Very grape.
So, yeah, I just
love it. Love it's it. Absolutely and it's beautiful.
Squishy soft.
Yes.
And, amazing. And when I went to Yarn Enabler and Yarn Therapist Table, I decided to buy from our other friend, Shauna, who is So You Say. I got this really cute little bag, because how could I not get this? And again, I should take it out of the bag.
Yeah.
Because it is so cute. It's a cute little project bag. And it's so funny, because when I picked it up, Amanda was like, oh, you and I have the same taste.
Yeah.
Look at the, isn't that the cutest thing? And then take a look at inside. So cute. I just love polka dots.
And there's her little iron-on.
Yeah. You see that? Isn't that just the sweetest thing? So
what a great little bag.
Yeah, it's that's just perfect. A cute
That'd be perfect
bag.
For a pair of socks. Pair of socks. The one ball. Yeah. It's a one ball bag.
Yeah. And so she's got a little... Some of I think she's
her, that's her hand sponge.
Her hand sponge. Yes. So she uses that on her zipper pull. And yeah, it's just a fun, cute little bag, and I can't wait to put something in it.
Mm-hmm.
So that was my big haul. And oh my gosh.
And you get the needles.
When we were there, one of the vendors was selling because it's something that I've been wanting to As I said, I've been wanting to try making socks, and I keep putting it off for no good reason, but I'm slowly gaining some of the tools that I know I'm going to need. And so many people who knit socks use different needles, and so along the way, I got the chai goose, and then I got these
Addy sock rockets.
And
there's so many people use those and like them, so it's like gotta try them.
Yeah, so this is a 32 inch 2.25 millimeter, which I think is the size 1 US.
Yes.
And a 32 inch or 80 centimeters. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna see what this is like. I have enough of the tools now that I need.
She has no excuse now.
So I think that was After we left Rosehaven too, we didn't mention we actually stopped by to see our dad.
Yes.
On the way.
Yes.
On the way home.
He lives in between Rosehaven and us and my house. And, so.
Yeah. So it was a really great excuse to stop in and see our dad
and have another washroom break.
Yes. and our stepmother. So
yeah.
It was. Oh my gosh. We had so much, and we are so overwhelmed with the warmth that we were met with.
Oh,
and the generosity
of
people.
By everyone, by the yarn shop girls and
Chelsea Yarns, Christina there, and the Crafty Toads of Toad Hollow.
Oh, yeah.
Mary Beth and Helen. Karen at Do You Knit.
Oh, yes.
And Leslie.
Karen actually on Instagram. So when are you guys actually going to be
here? Yeah, she messaged us and
said, I know you're in Jersey.
When are you stopping by? Yeah. So that was really great.
It was.
You know, people just opening themselves up to us.
That was fabulous.
It was surprising, and it was lovely and generous. And
so nice.
And then Leslie at Rosehaven.
Oh,
everybody
was so wonderful.
And so it was, I have to say, it was very nice getting back home to sleep in my own bed. But wonderful adventure.
Oh, it was a fabulous trip. Absolutely fabulous trip. We just had so much fun. And we are now, from now on, going to be stash busting because we don't need any more for a while. As much as everybody's like, oh, you always need new. Yeah, you know, I do get that. Believe me, I could buy until the cows come home.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I want to try to use some of this stuff up now.
So we've been looking at patterns, and we've been talking.
Oh, that would be nice with this. Oh, that would be nice with this.
So we have a few ideas. Mm-hmm. Not 100% sure yet if that's where we're going to go with them, but we're working towards that. But we've got to get a few things done.
And we're also working on maybe putting together a knit-along.
Yes.
So we've got some ideas
floating about that. Mm-hmm. So other than that, I think we should sign off. So thanks so much for joining us. If it's your first time, please, I hope you enjoyed it enough to subscribe.
Yep.
And if you are returning, thank you so much for coming back. And we will see you next time.
Oh, and don't forget, you can join our Ravelry group as well.
Oh, that's right. So we'll put some of the information at the very end.
Usually it's our show notes are on our Ravelry group page.
Yes. So do stop by, join the group, and we will see you next time.